Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. My name is Erin, and today it's Book Review Friday. So today's book review is a little different because it's not really a full book. It's like a short novella kind of thing. It's Blanky by, how do you say his name? Kealan Patrick Burke. Is it Kealan? I think it's Kealan. I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name. So this is like really short. It's like only like 70 some pages. I think, yeah, 73 pages, 74. So it's really, really short. If you saw my haul that I just posted, I bought this off of Amazon and there's three others that are short. So I'm gonna review those too, even though they're like short. I still wanna like include them in my book reviews. So let's talk about the cover. So it's called Blanky, which is super funny because I have a blanket that I've had since I was a baby and I named it Blanky. So like that hits a little too close to home for me because this is a scary story. But it's a matte black cover, which I love matte covers. They are my favorite. The soft touch matte are literally to die for. But it has a like an old timey baby carriage in there. And then it's just like really simple and plain. I think it looks really cool. I actually really like it. Yeah. So let's talk about the back of the book. Let me read it to you. In the wake of his infant daughter's tragic death, Steve Branigan is struggling to keep himself together. Estranged from his wife who refuses to be inside the house where the unthinkable happened, and unable to work, he seeks solace in an endless parade of old sitcoms and a bottle of bourbon. Until one night he hears a sound from his daughter's old room, a room now stripped bare of anything that identified it as hers, except for her security blanket, affectionately known as Blanky. Blanky, old and frayed with its antiqued patchwork of badly sewn rabbits with black button eyes who appear to be staring at the viewer. Blanky, purchased from a strange old man at an antique stall selling baby clothes at a discount. The presence of Blanky in his dead daughter's room heralds nothing short of an unspeakable nightmare that threatens to take away what little light remains in Steve's shattered world. I call him Steve, I'm sorry. Because his daughter loved Blanky so much, he buried her with it. So, yeah. So that got me, because I didn't read the back of these books. I had no idea what they were. So when I read that and I was like, well, why is the blanket so scary? And then it was like, he buried the daughter with it. And I was like, ew, that's freaky. So let's talk about it. Steve is the dad to the baby that died. The baby's name is Robin. And him and his wife are having issues because she can't really get over the fact that their baby died, which, I mean, totally get it. That's a horrific tragedy that, like, I can't even imagine. So he's living in that house by himself, and the wife is living with her parents because she just can't bear to be in the room. Well, actually, in the house. She just doesn't want to be around it. And he's trying to get them back together because he just misses her so much, and he's so devastated, and the only thing he has is her left. And he just wants her and him to, like, you know, like, reconcile so they can be, like, comfort for each other while their baby has died. So one night he calls her and he's like, can we talk, blah, blah. And she's like, you know, I don't really want to talk to you. Like, you know, I just can't. This is, like, you're pushing it. I don't want to talk. So he, like, leaves her alone. And then he hears moving coming from upstairs. And he's like, that's weird. And he sees his daughter's room, like, it's coming from that. So he goes inside and her baby blanket is just laying on the floor. And he's like, that's weird. I wonder how it got here because we, like, took everything out. It's all put away. It shouldn't be here. So he, like, picks it up and he, like, feels strange. So he calls his wife and he's like, hey, I found Robin's baby blanket. And she was like, what, really? Where? Like, and she, you know, he told her and she was like, can I come over and get it? I want it. And he was like, yeah, of course, like, come over. And he was like, this is my chance to, like, make it work between us, you know, whatever. And so she comes over and they start reconciling. Like, it works. Like, she starts realizing that, like, you know, they're all each other has, like, whatever. So things start getting really good for him, like, really good. Like, she is, they're back in the relationship, they're going on dates. She's not living with him just yet, but they're planning on moving back in together into the house. She just can't do it right now. And they're doing really good. And then his wife dies. I'm not going to tell you how because it correlates to the baby's death, so I don't want to give that away. I want you to read it for yourself. But basically, the blanket is the cause of the baby's death and now his wife's death. So he's just devastated. I mean, it's one thing after another, but he knows it's the blanket. He knows that it's this blanket. So he goes on this hunt to try to figure out what to do. Like, he's like, you know, I need to figure out where this baby blanket is coming from. You know what I'm talking about? And all the while, he's having these weird, like, vivid dreams. And I'm not 100% sure if they're dreams or if they're actually happening sometimes. So basically, he sees this witch in a witch's house, and it's like her house, and she's like weird. She has like baby fingers in like her eyes and stuff like that. It's very strange. Like, she makes this tapping noise, like, I don't know, it's like really friggin' weird. And like, he like, it's like vivid though, you know, so I can't tell if those are like real or not real. Do you know what I'm saying? So that happens, and then, you know, he decides to go after this little old man who was selling baby clothes at that, like, flea market. I think it was a flea market, and the way he spelled baby clothes, it's like baby and then C-L-O-S-E, like clothes, like close the door, not like clothes, you know what I'm saying? So that's why they remembered it, because like it was spelled wrong. So he goes after the man, and like he finds him, and he's like talking to him, but the man doesn't know who he is. He's like, I sell a lot of baby clothes. I sell a lot of baby things. Like, I don't know what you're talking about. And Steve is like, no, you know what I'm talking about. So he follows him to his house. And this is pretty much the end of the book, when he follows him to his house and like confronts him. It's, stuff happens. A lot of stuff happens there. It's a very, it's interesting. And that's the ending. So, the ending. Let's talk about the ending. I'm not going to tell you how it ends because it has something to do with the old man. But I will say it kind of leaves you questioning if Steve is what you think he is. Because all this time you think Steve is completely innocent and nice and he's grieving. And he's just this grieving dad, and now a grieving dad and husband, you know? And you're like on his team. And then at the end, something happens and it changes slightly. Is he a grieving man, or is he grieving, but it overtakes him completely and makes him into something that he isn't? Does that make sense? I don't want to give it away. This book is talking about grieving, but I don't know if the grieving is going into a normal, natural grieving process or a strange and slightly terrifying grieving process, because there are some situations that happen at the end that you find out about that have a different tone than you were reading previously. So I'm confused at the ending because I don't know what to think about Steve anymore. I don't know if Steve is the nice guy I thought he was or if he's something else. And I don't know exactly what to believe. I'm pretty sure Kealan Patrick Burke did that on purpose to make you feel, like, strange. It definitely is a very, like, a deep-rooted book in grieving, which I think is interesting because you don't see too much of that. Most horror and grieving is, like, Pet Sematary, where they're grieving and then they, like, bring their baby back to life, and then it's, like, way to go, because it's not your baby, you know, if you've seen Pet Sematary. Then if you didn't, you don't know what I'm talking about, but it's fine. So, yeah, it's a very interesting book. It's very fast-paced because there's only, like, 73 pages, which I think is nice because it's a very good length. Like, if it was more, it would have been annoying, and if it was less, it would have been too fast. So I think it was a nice, you know, speed. I like that. But, yeah, I'm excited to read his other books. This was very interesting for a first one. And I have some other interesting ones that I read the back of, and I was just kind of like, okay. So I'm very intrigued. It's, he has some unique ideas from what I've been reading the back of his books. They've been pretty like, whoa, that's different. So yeah, I'm pretty excited to read his other books. I really like this. It was a little strange at the end. So yeah, let me know if you've read this or if you've read any of his other like short novels, novellas, whatever you want to call them. And then his other books. I know he has like Kin, which I bought, and some other books, but like Turtle Boy, I think, the Turtle Boy. I don't have that one, but let me know if you've read anything by him, what you think about this book, if you've read it or whatever. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know in the comments down below if you like the sound of this or if you don't. So yeah, like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you guys later. Bye.